Hi, I'm Richard Bender. I teach the Writing Testable Requirements course in conjunction with SQE. The reason we put the course together was we have been teaching how to find ambiguities in requirements. That's always been part of our requirements-based testing process for years. And we got really good at destroying specs. And then our clients would come back and say, okay, now that you've destroyed them, how do we fix them? And we kept referring to them, well, there's a lot of good requirements courses out there. Go attend them, and hopefully that'll give you the information you need. And what we found was, they came back with a lot of knowledge about how to do modeling, the high-level stuff, but not the real detail, case-by-case, how do I write these things absolutely clearly, the right level of detail, right level of organization clarity. And so we wound up evolving the material as a byproduct of a lot of projects, coming up with initially a style guide on how to write a good requirement. And then we evolved that into what became, after a number of years of applying the process, the Writing Testable Requirements course. So the focus of that course is, how do we write a requirement that's unambiguous, proper level of detail, it's clear to all the users of that material, all the readers of it, and the approach is not tied into the methodology of the week. So we've been doing this when people are using the old structured techniques, then the information engineering techniques, now with UML. And so we're agnostic on the format of the material that focuses on the content of how to write a good requirement. The other thing we've started evolving and adding into it in recent years is people fortunately have finally started migrating into requirement management tools, repositories. I mean, the last major vestige of paper in the software industry happens to be the requirements. We spent the last 4 or 5 decades automating everybody else except ourselves. And what we see people doing is primarily using requirement management tools as version control for Word documents, which is not the intent. It's to create a database of requirements, and just like any application database, you can take different views. So what we build into the Writing Testable Requirements course is that inventory of attributes about use cases, about functions, about data flows and data stores, the details of everything you would need to know and how to organize it and how this then works with the repositories. In addition to, if all you have is Word and Visio and Excel, it'll still work in that. So the material, the course, is very much a workshop-oriented. It's one where I teach a little bit, these students work out some problems, I teach a little bit more, they work out more problems, I teach a little bit more, they work out lots of problems. So I find it a very relaxing way to spend 3 days. And the students are probably spending at least 60% of their time in workshop mode. Because you don't learn how to do things listening to an instructor. You learn how to do it hands-on, trying to do it. And a lot of the exercises are team exercises. So they're breaking up the work, they're taking pieces, the other people are doing pieces. They got to make sure the pieces fit together. They're actually reviewing each other's work against the criteria they've just learned. So it's a very practical kind of approach, very workshop-oriented, very practical, and applies to any class of application. We've used this on classic business applications, but also operating systems, embedded systems, supercomputer-based systems. So it covers any application you will ever write in your entire lifetime. Is somewhere the material is there to cover it.